Hi guys, today I'm going to be doing the reading your assumptions about me video and also answer your questions all in this video. So let's go. The first assumption is you've been gone so long because you're secretly pregnant. You pregnant. No, girl, I'm just fat. Just fat, okay? I'm not pregnant. I'm just fat. That was a lot of it. I'm not pregnant. I just put on a couple pounds, okay? You guys keep commenting underneath my pictures. Are you pregnant? Are you pregnant? Do you know what that does for my self-esteem? I'm joking. No, guys, I'm not pregnant. You want to have a small wedding? Yes. I really want a small wedding. I don't want to be paying for people that I don't even know. Like, I don't even know you, but I'm paying per head. I didn't even know weddings were per head until recently. And I'm paying for Jaquisa's sisters, cousins, aunties, uncles, brothers to come and chop. No. No thank you. I only want like my day ones at my wedding. People that actually like ride for me, support me. I want a small wedding. Coming from an African background, I don't think it's possible. I assume that you will read this message. I see what you did there. Your blood is pink. This is true. Your favorite color is pink. This is not true. My favorite color is gold because I like to shine. Why would your favorite color not be like gold or silver? It's the most shiniest one. Everyone thinks I love pink because I have pink hair and pink nails. I don't mind pink, but it's definitely not my favorite color. You would like to get married next year. Would I like to be married next year? To be honest with you, nah. To be honest with you, nah, I don't want to get married next year. Just because I know that it costs a lot next year. I'm still a baby girl, living my life. And also, I've always, like, in my life plan, I always said I would have a house before I get married. I always knew that. I wanted to own a property before I have a marriage that might cost me a fortune. I'd rather have a property. So, let me take a few years to, like, sort everything out. Oh, Beyonce got energy. Chat, she got energy. You're the type of person to beat your face, take hours doing your makeup, to do nothing and just stay at home. Girl, you been watching me? Guys, I do this every day. I pack my face with makeup. Not every day, sometimes, but most times, yeah, I'm not gonna, like today. I ain't doing nothing, chat. I'm just staying at home, but I wanted to get my face up real quick. Beat y'all like? Is it true you have an attitude? Do you know what? I'm not gonna lie, I'm from Southeast London. I do think I got a little bit of an attitude. Just in the blood, it's out of the blood. But I hate when people think like I'm this like buttercup girl and like whenever I say something like don't do that, everyone's like, oh! I hate that. No, I'm from Southeast London. I'm Nigerian and Ghanaian. Come on, I've got all these flavors in me. Of course I've got an attitude. But you will only see the attitude if it's called for. Naturally, I'm not the sort of person that just like has an attitude for no reason. No, I only have an attitude if it's called for. If I have to defend myself, I learned that from my housemate Bianca. She really taught me, speak up, don't let these people run you. Sometimes you gotta speak up and stand up for yourself, okay? Trust me, you have to learn that the hard way. You love Beyonce. Yeah, I think everyone knows that. I don't think that's an assumption. I think everyone knows that I love Beyonce, like proper. You are very reserved. No. I mean, sometimes I'm pretty chill and I don't really say too much, and sometimes I'm the loudest person in the room. I know, like, I don't know. Isn't everyone like that? I'm a misfit, like, I actually don't know. Sometimes I'm so loud and I'm proper like, yeah, let's go out. And other times I'm like, people will be like, Mimi, let's go here. And I'll be like, you mean leave? Like, leave the house? I put on my shoes and actually leave? No. Like, sometimes I'm probably like, I just want to stay in my house. I go through my phases. I assume that nothing has changed, still the same. Hey, shout out Dami, he went to my uni. You right. I'm still the same. You were the pretty girl in school. What? Me? You guys. Wait, you're too funny. I can't even. Let me just. I was 100% not the pretty girl in school. Like, I was far from it. After for my mama to, I was like that. I was pretty and not. I wasn't even under for mama to, babe. I was like, no, 100%. I was like a tomboy. Like, I played hockey. I used to like do a little bit of like eyeliner here and there, but I feel like everyone goes through stages where they change. I mean, some people have always been cute, like cute from the beginning. I see pictures, I'm like, damn, bro, you were always cute. Like, you never had that stage of like being a little bit ugly. Like, you were always pretty. But no, I was definitely not the pretty girl in school. But it's okay, because I'm a spice of life now. I'm joking. I assume you and Aaliyah don't speak anymore. No, guys, why are people saying this? Like, I'm literally meeting up with Aaliyah. Like, when you guys don't see people together, it's like, oh, y'all must be fighting. They must not be talking. Kind of live far from each other. Used to like both go to so many events, and we'll always be together. But now, like, we hardly go to events. But that being said, we are going to an event tomorrow together and next week. So y'all see her tomorrow. I'm probably gonna vlog tomorrow. Me and her are doing a shoot together. We're doing like a Mother's Day shoot with this brand, which you guys will see. So she's doing a shoot with her mom, and I'm doing a shoot with my mom. But we cool. That's my sis for life. Period. Like, Aaliyah proper like helped me out so much. That's my sister. So if you don't see us together, what other things have you assumed about me? I assumed you were on a TV ad. Yes, girl. I was on a TV ad. I was on a New Life TV ad. Oh my God, it's so weird seeing my face like everywhere. I've already recorded a whole video about that. I'm editing it right now. So that should be out next week. I think you're a real one and stay true to who you are, which is beautiful, amazing, different, weird, smart. And I like that you don't try to change. Gracie Smith, that was so sweet. Thank you so much. I'm not gonna lie, growing up, I was like, oh, I feel like I'm too different. Like, what's going on? Like, I tried to fit in a lot, and now I just don't care. That's why people are like, oh my God, you have black hair, and you're wearing like blazers and stuff. And then sometimes you see me wearing chunky wedges with baby pink hair. Like, I don't know, I just like a lot of different things, and that's just who I am. Like, it's not an assumption, I just wanna say I love you. Oh, girl, I love you too. On that note, I think that's a beautiful one to leave it on. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you are wondering, this hair is actually from Unice. I did a whole video about it, which I'll link down below in the description bar. They sent me inches 16 frontal, 28, 28, 30, and 30. Again, I have a whole video listed down below, and all the details to the hair will be in the description bar if you guys are interested. The hair's holding up really, really well. Again, Unice is processed hair, so when you get it, it does look really silky and smooth. Unlike virgin hair, it doesn't last as long because of the shedding, but it does look really beautiful for like birthdays. The hair too much. That's just my personal opinion. However, I still love the hair. I think this is the second or the third time that I've ordered hair from Unice, so that's an A+ that I'm using the hair. Again, I do recommend this hair for like birthday celebrations, graduations, because it looks really, really nice and silky and smooth when you get it out of the packet. Again, all the details will be linked down below. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.